The behavior modification program is set up for dogs and cats, who I usually say are at the opposite ends of the spectrum, behaviorally speaking. So they're either fearful, anxious, nervous, shut down, scared, timid, or they're hyperactive, reactive. So they're kind of like on the outside. Oh, Edgar. When Edgar first came in, he was all over the place. Like, just every thought that he had in his brain, he would just do it. There was no internal editor. He was unable to settle. I mean, constantly pacing, panting, would lay down for half a second and then jump right back up again. So getting him to actually sit and settle and like actively chill was a big component of his program. So when Edgar was quite young, he was hit by a car. That caused some vision impairment on one of the sides of his face, on one eye.
Which is why his face is all like smushed and it's really hard to take pictures of him.
And there's also some vision loss. So there's like that physical disability kind of keyed into it. But then also he had behavioral issues on top of that.
Edgar needed someone that wanted him and loved him for like being an Edgar and didn't want him to be something he's not.
About 2 years ago, I had gone out for a Saturday morning run, and I was involved in a hit-and-run pedestrian accident. So I was hit by a car and tossed over the hood. Broken nose, a lot of bruises, couldn't run for like 6 weeks. Yeah, just kind of beat up, like not super great. It was a whole process of healing, recovering, getting back to normal, getting back outside. You know, thankfully my nose set straight, but if only mine had set crooked too, then we would really be twins.
It was certainly serendipity. When I saw that he had been found just on the street after being hit by a car, it broke my heart.
Sometimes there's that thread where you keep coming back to things and you just kind of feel it. So we kept coming back to Edgar with, you know, he's still there.
It took us a little while to learn Edgar's language. By the end of those meetings, it was like, okay, we feel equipped to do this.
Mm-hmm.
And they told us, hey, you've got additional support if you need it.
We knew that here in the behavior modification program, we would be able to help him. Like, we have the tools available to be able to get him to where he needs to be successful in a home. There is no cookie cutter program because there's no cookie cutter dogs.
The work that the behavior modification program did is basically help him work through that reactivity, help him understand how to get out energy in a productive way, how to do his best to contain his enthusiasm.
I believe every dog deserves that chance to like be the best version of themselves and have that extra support from like staff and the community so we can say, hey, you know, this dog can be successful.
Oh my goodness. Hi. Seeing him today and just seeing how confident he is and how secure he is with his family and in his new life, it's very rewarding.
I knew he could do this. He just needed someone in his corner to kind of fight for him and to be able to like meet him where he's at and put in that training. And seeing it like actually like happen after a few months is amazing.
We're just so excited to have this guy and have him go on adventures with us, like go camping, go running, go hiking, go trail running.
Go to the beach.
And then I think we're also really excited to just have the little quiet moments with him. I mean, he's got all the energy in the world, but then he loves to just relax and hang out, and it is just such a wonderful little unspoken bond that we have with him, where he's able to be there for us and we're able to be there for him.